Now, this doesn't happen with men because men keep on producing hundreds of millions of new sperm every day. Men have stem cells in their testicles that make sperm every day. With women, all the eggs that you ever have are what you're born with, and 1,000 of them die every month. So it may seem very unfair biologically, but men continue to be fertile as they get older, but women don't. So there is very little age-related decline in fertility in men. However, in women, there is a dramatic age-related decline in fertility, so that by the time you're in your late 20s, about 16% of women are infertile, and by the time you're in mid-30s, 25% are infertile. And it's only because of the aging of your eggs. But some women will be very fertile when they're 40 or 42 even and have many eggs. And other women will have run out of their eggs by the time they're 23 or 24 and be infertile in their early 20s. So the question is, where are you on your biological clock? For example, if you're 23 and you were to know that you have so many eggs that you're not going to become infertile until you're 42, you could plan your life with greater assurance and do what you want to do prior to worrying about getting married and having children. But what if you were 23 and you found out you only had a few more years of fertility left? Well, then you'd have to do some careful planning. On the other hand, what if you're 38 and you're very, very concerned because you think you may not be able to have any more children? If you were to know that you're one of those 38-year-olds, that would sure take a lot of pressure and a lot of anxiety off of your living. So, how do we find this out? Before I actually tell you about the testing you can do, which is very cheap and simple, and what you can do to preserve your fertility, I just want to read a little note from my logbooks when I spent some time with the Hadzi Bushmen, a 40,000-year-old Stone Age hunter-gatherer culture in Africa. I'm very fascinated by ancient cultures. So let me read from this. When I lived a short while with the Hadzi Bushmen in the most remote region of Africa, it's a 40,000-year-old Stone Age hunter-gatherer culture, I asked them about infertility, and they had no idea what I was talking about. See, I was an infertility doctor from the United States, and I wanted to know whether infertility, which is a huge plague in the Western world, and in developing Asia, whether this is a problem in an ancient culture such as theirs. I mean, these people would get up at 6:30 in the morning and go hunting and gathering all day long, and then go to sleep 6:30 at night when the sun went down, 7 days a week. It's a very, very ancient, basic culture. They had no huts, no place to live, no agriculture, and they didn't have any domesticated animals. But it represents how we lived 40,000 years ago. They're the same as us physically and genetically, but they just have an ancient, undeveloped, so to speak, uncivilized culture. So let me read from this. They could not imagine a woman not becoming pregnant or bearing children. It would be a very, very rare woman with such a curse, they would call it. But the Hadzi get married at age 15, and the average life expectancy is 33. Our biology, our human biology, has not changed in 40,000 years. All that has changed is our culture, particularly in the last half century. Thus, the average modern American, European, or even modern Indian or Chinese woman does not usually contemplate having children nowadays until she's in her late 20s or 30s or even 40s. When China several decades ago recognized their overpopulation problem and passed a law in 1970s that couples could not get married until age 26, their infertility rate went from 1% to 12%. Putting off getting pregnant, even in your 20s, dramatically decreases the chance of you being fertile. And by their late 30s, most women are infertile. So we know that this is true in any culture, anywhere around the world, that menopause on average occurs at age 51. In some women, in any culture, it'll occur very early, like age 20 or 25. In other women, maybe age 60. There's a huge variation in your ovarian reserve. There's a huge variation in your where you are in your biologic clock. And if you know where you are, you can plan your life better. Now here is a diagram of human chromosomes. As you may know, we have 22 autosomes, and then we have either an X and a Y if we're a male, or two X's if we're a female. So basically 24 different chromosomes, but it's 23 pairs of chromosomes. Now you have to have this exact number. If the egg or the sperm unite so that you have an extra chromosome or a missing chromosome, then it's really not compatible with life or normal life. And it leads either to a miscarriage, to not getting pregnant, or in the extreme case where it's an extra copy of chromosome 21, to a Down syndrome. But it's all a different expression of the same phenomenon, a chromosomal abnormality. Now, here you'll see better what I'm talking about. Above is a normal human set of chromosomes, 22 pairs of autosomes and an X and a Y. It's a male. But you see in the Down syndrome case, below on the bottom, there are three copies in that square of chromosome 21. And so when you have an extra copy of a chromosome, or you're missing a copy of a chromosome, then that means too many or too few genes, and it screws everything up. Down syndrome, it's such a small gene with so few, it's such a small chromosome with so few genes on it, that it's actually compatible with life in 20% of cases, but it's an abnormality. But 80% of Down syndrome are also miscarried. And you see all these other chromosomes, if they're not arranged exactly right, if there's a genetic error in the egg, then that can't be a viable embryo, and it can't result in life. So what happens here, when the egg is maturing, and this diagram may be a little hard to follow, but when the, and this is from a textbook that I wrote, so it's not exactly designed for consumers, but nonetheless, you might get an idea. When the egg is normally maturing, chromosomes will split off so that every cell in your body has 46 chromosomes. But when that egg matures, it splits in half, so you only have 23 chromosomes. And then the sperm does the same thing. So you have a sperm with 23 chromosomes meeting an egg with 23 chromosomes, and you wind up with a fertilized egg or an embryo that has the normal number of 46 chromosomes, like every cell in your body. Now, if you have 47 chromosomes or 45 chromosomes instead of the normal 46, it's not compatible with life, and you either are infertile because that egg never develops or implants, or if it does develop or implant, it results in a miscarriage because it was never normal to start with. Now, here's the point. As your eggs get older, there's a greater and greater likelihood that as they mature and prepare for ovulation, these chromosomes don't split equally. And you basically have an abnormal egg that's programmed for death and can't result in pregnancy. That is one of the reasons why you become infertile as you get older. Your eggs age. And here's just a simple graph showing that the chance of getting pregnant goes down as you get older, as the abnormality frequency in the eggs increase.